Good morning, caller.
Hello, good morning.
Yes, we hear you.
I'm sorry?
We can hear you loud and clear.
Okay, good. Listen, last week was the first time that I tuned into your program.
Yes.
And I've got a very basic, fundamental question, I guess.
Sure.
If Christians believe that God made the heavens and earth, and if that's not so, what's an atheist viewpoint? What's comparable to that?
Well, let me take a shot at that.
Turn that back down.
Essentially, all one needs to be an atheist, Eli, is to confirm to yourself that the reality around us, the material, physical reality that we can all see and test with our senses, is as we find it, and it doesn't lie to us, and it tells us the truth. And essentially, my position is I accept a material reality. All the evidence I have tells me that reality is an orderly reality of consistent physical laws, that there's nothing supernatural or magical happens that can violate the physical laws. And through all the experience of my life, I never find anything that says there's something out there magical, supernatural, that can violate the physical laws of the universe. So for me, all of existence around me is my confirmation of the reality that I live in, and that's the reality that I accept, and I don't see any evidence that pushes me to an idea that says there's more, there's some kind of magical super being out there that can, by an act of will, decide that it's going to violate the law of gravity or the speed of light or something of that nature.
Okay, very good point. Laws of the universe, and the laws of the universe just came to existence how?
They've always been there. They always will be. No one created them. That's just, they're there, and they will always be there.
We don't quite know this, but you're telling me.
Well, there are unknowns. Human knowledge is not complete. Human knowledge is not perfect. Basically, I'm going on the knowledge that we do have. That says that we live in a universe of consistent physical laws of matter and energy.
Right. But an atheist really, you guys don't embark on trying to understand how that started.
No. Every day we're learning new things, and it's a constant journey there, wouldn't you say, Joe?
Atheists support the pursuit of these answers through science, though, and not superstition. We find that a whole lot more truth and reality has been found through science, and the beginning of that would be doubt. Someone doubted something they heard, and very often from superstition, and went out using science and actually found the truth.
So proof through science.
So there's a whole lot better track record with science.
I can understand that.
Caller?
So basically, you guys kind of believe in evolution.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely. Let me paint a picture for you and get your viewpoint on this.
Try.
Evolution is basically the survival of the fittest.
One, sure.
Someone is able to survive in its environment, acclimate itself to this environment. Is that a true statement?
That's a simplification. Evolution is the descent with modification through the process of natural selection. Life forms do not modify themselves during their lives. They exist within the environment, and depending on how well their adaptations are for that environment, they'll either survive or not, and of course chance plays a part in it also.
Go ahead, Kelly. You seem like you had a point that you were going to.
Well, no, I kind of wanted some clarification. Well, a question that I have, and I've asked a lot of people this, and, because I am a Christian, but I've got a lot of questions about the Bible, and I've got a lot of questions about evolution.
Yeah.
I keep an open mind on both ends.
Right.
But a question that I have, and I've asked an evolutionist this, is one of the theories that an evolutionist has is that at some point a fish got close to land and it eventually grew legs and it became a land-dwelling creature.
Well, no, not one fish all of a sudden got up there and grew legs. Like you're saying, they were out there walking on their fins, and those fins, over many, 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 many generations, adapted into, you know, the fish adapted to the land there, yes.
Yeah.
We actually went through an amphibian first, and then...
Yeah, it's a process, a very long one. That's the problem I find that a lot of Christians have with evolution, is that they're not able to think of it in terms of millions of years. And evolution certainly does not happen within one generation, like you were saying, Howard. It just doesn't happen that fast. It's a lot more complex than that, basically.
Well, no, I understand that. Well, that's basically all the questions I had.
Well, we appreciate your call.
Okay.
You have a good day.
Thank you.